This is a small and very popular smart temperature and humidity sensor manufactured by Xiaomi. And now it can be flashed with a custom firmware that will make it a Zigbee device. This smart sensor costs around $5 and by default it is using an encrypted Bluetooth to announce its readings remotely to the Xiaomi mobile phone app, which is boring. The good thing is that there is an easy way to decrypt that Bluetooth communication and to use that sensor inside Home Assistant as I have described in this video of mine. Unfortunately, this process doesn't work every time, at least for me. It seems that it depends on the device firmware version, and even if you make it work, the device is going unavailable very often. There is a second option, which is to install a custom Bluetooth firmware on this little guy, and I described that in another video. This option is slightly better in terms of reliability, but it is not working on all devices for some reason. Gladly, there is now a third and mind-blowing option, which makes the temperature sensor a Zigbee device. I'm not sure how this is even possible, but because it is so easy, I tried it out and everything seems to work good. Actually, it is working great, at least for now. What is even better is that not only this Xiaomi device is supported, and there are more. At the time of shooting this video, these are the devices that can use the new Zigbee custom firmware. That means the same steps that you're about to see now can be done on any of these devices. You can find links to all of them in the video description. Along with the one or more of these supported devices, you also need a Zigbee hub, also known as controller or Zigbee bridge, which will allow you to connect to that new Zigbee temperature and humidity sensor remotely. Examples of such Zigbee hub devices are Home Assistant Yellow, Sky Connect USB dongle, Conbee stick, Samsung SmartThings V3 and more. Also, for best-in-class experience, you need a working Home Assistant. If you don't have such yet, then join my Home Assistant webinar for free and learn everything essential about it. And now, let me show you what I did to upload the Zigbee firmware on my little Xiaomi temperature and humidity sensor. I opened the GitHub page of the custom firmware for Zigbee 3.0 IoT devices on the TLSR825X chips. And I'll open this web page. This is the TELINK flasher that we are going to use. And because I'm using Chrome, I'll copy this link address. I'll open another tab and I'll paste the link here. I'll hit enter, and this is what I wanted to change. Experimental web platform features should be enabled. It is disabled by default. I will enable it and I'll click on relaunch. This will start my Chrome browser again. But this time, this feature is now enabled. I'll close this and I'll return back to the TELINK flasher and I'll click on this connect button. Then I'll search for my device, my Xiaomi device with the easy to remember name, LY something. Here it is. I'll click on it and I'll click on pair. Connecting to Xiaomi device. Connected, you can now do activation to either get token or flash a new firmware, and I will do exactly that. I'll click on do activation. Activating now, please wait. This is my token, this is my bind key, and everything seems fine. And from these buttons right here, I can flash either the custom Bluetooth firmware, I can also flash the Zigbee firmware, I can also revert back the original firmware of the Xiaomi device if I wish to, but not this time. This time I want this Zigbee firmware and I'll click on it. This dialog is telling me that this is a beta version for testing and converts the thermometer to a Zigbee protocol. All data for Mi Home and measurement memory will be erased. I'm okay with that and I'll just click on OK. And then you can see here that the firmware is ready to be downloaded and installed, and I just have to click on start flashing like that and sending blocks starting. This is the device still working for now, showing some readings which are matching these readings right here. 50% done for 50 seconds. Great. Update done after 121 seconds. Great. My device is showing zeros for some reason. And now it's fine. Some kind of restart or something. But it seems that it is working. Display is looking exactly the same as before. I'm not sure. Is it visible on the camera? But it is showing some readings. A face, which is not very happy. And the humidity readings in percentages. Now, Home Assistant. Now go to Settings, Devices and Services. And here it is. This is a temperature and humidity sensor, but BLE one. I don't want that. I want the Zigbee one. In order to use that sensor that way, you need a Zigbee hub. I'm using Home Assistant Yellow, which have a Zigbee hub embedded. If that's not the case for you, you can use any Zigbee dongle like Sky Connect, for example, or Conbee or something else to enable Zigbee for your setup. And once you have that, you should add a Zigbee integration in your Home Assistant, such as this Zigbee Home Automation. This is very easy, you just have to click on Add Integration and you have to search for Zigbee Home Automation and then to install it. Nothing else. Because I already have it, I am unable to add it again and I can only add devices by clicking on Add Integration and add Zigbee device, or I can directly click on the integration, configure, add device. It is the same. After flashing, the device should show up in your Zigbee bridge. If not, try reinserting the battery or short-circuiting the reset and ground pins on the Xiaomi device. And now this should find my small temperature and humidity sensor eventually, and I should add it that way. Great, it found it. The device is ready to use. Great, that was fast and easy. I can choose an area, bedroom for example. I can change the name. I'll leave it like that. And I'm ready. Actually, I have nothing else to do. Here it is. I have the temperature readings. I also have a button to identify my sensor. If I press it, the Bluetooth icon start blinking on the device. Good, I can identify this that way. I also have the humidity, which is exactly the same as on the display. And I have the battery. I can go back one more time. And if I open my Zigbee Home Automation, I can see the device here. Here it is. I can add these readings to my dashboard by clicking on Add to Dashboard. And I can make an automation. For example, if the temperature goes above or below some threshold, start the heating or the AC, it doesn't matter. And just like that, my little Xiaomi sensor becomes a Zigbee device and I can use it in my Zigbee network, which is very, very impressive. Don't you think? My main concern now is the battery life. From what I managed to read, there were some drain issues in the past, but now these bugs should be fixed. If you try this out, let me know in the comments about your experience. Is it working for you? Is your battery fine? And basically everything that could help others. Grab my smart home glossary for free. It is one big PDF file full of smart home wisdom. I'm Kirill, thanks for watching. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye!